Hello guys, and welcome back. Some of you have requested a little further explanation of the calculator and maybe even a full tutorial, so I'm gonna go a little deeper this time and I'm gonna explain how to set this up and give you everything you need to get going with your own calculator build or something different that uses this mechanic. I have some good news and I have some bad news though. Because the bad news is that we are gonna talk a little math, and the good news is that you don't actually have to understand it, you just need to accept that it is so, and then you're good to go. If you just want to see the calculator again, or if you haven't seen it already, I recommend skipping the geek talk and just click this link to get to the original video. We are gonna talk about the speed of the wheel, which is a key factor in this build. Because while it would be convenient for the builder if the rotation or revolution, if you will, of the wheel with the speed set to 1 was fixed to an easily divided number like 6, 8 or 10 seconds, but instead the wheel rotation speed is set to an immediately inconvenient number of 6.28318531 etc. seconds for each rotation or revolution. And this doesn't seem obvious if you don't know what is going on, so let me give you the light version. The wheel rotation is set to what in math is called the tau constant. The tau constant is used to represent a ratio, usually the ratio of a circle's circumference to its radius, written like tau equals circumference divided with the radius. And the answer is a constant that always equals the infinite number 6.28318531 etc. We are gonna cut it short and say it almost equals 6.28. Another way to put it is that the tau constant equals 2 times pi. This number is important in engineering and physics because it can be used to calculate the area of a circle. And furthermore, the tau constant serves to define the trigonometric functions, which are essential for solving many types of equations, basically everything that involves triangles. The speed is a fixed gear ratio. The gear ratio between the wheel and the axle is 1:1. Meaning that for each revolution of the axle, the wheel makes one full rotation, and when the speed is set to be worth 1 of itself, it will create the speed of 6.28 seconds for each rotation. So let's put it to the test, shall we? If I build a wheel with a little indicator on, and we set the speed to 1, and then make the wheel rotate in 6.28 seconds, it should end up pretty much where it started. How we're gonna do this is we are gonna place a delay and then set the delay to 6.28 seconds. It would be more accurate to write more digits of tau, but the game doesn't allow, so we go with 6.28. Now we are gonna connect the switch to the wheel so it will start to rotate, and then connect the switch to the delay so it sends the signal, and then connect the delay to the wheel also, so that with a 6.28 seconds delay, it will tell the wheel to stop rotating. And I should just remember to set the speed value to be worth 1 of itself. Now let's see what happens. And that is pretty much as perfect as it gets. Now, if I was about to set the speed of the wheel to 0.5, meaning being worth 1/2 of itself, I would have to set the delay to 2 times the tau constant, that means 12.56. The maximum of one delay block is 10, so I use 2 and set one of them to 10, and the other to 2.56. So it's 12.56 combined. And let's see how that goes. And And that is perfect once again. So now with that being sorted out, now it's time to build your rotating wheel with your numbers or blocks or whatever around it, around the circumference of it. And it doesn't matter how long you make this, you just need to use the amount of segments around the wheel in your calculation in a minute, and it will be obvious. Now you just copy and move it back down in the same position, and then you rotate it, and then you choose the both of them, and you copy and move it back into same position and rotate it like this. And now it gets a little tricky, because maybe if the axle is not the right way like this, if the axle is the wrong way like this here, then you just hold down shift and uncheck and check again one of the blocks that you want to be your reference for the axle. Now you move this one, and now sometimes the arrows, they don't align, they change the axle, but then you do this trick if they does. Now you move it back and you rotate it just once like this. Now again, you copy, and now if the arrows change like they do here, you hold down shift and click it again, your reference block, and now you can move it back to do like this. Now we have the 24 segments around it that I used in my calculation, but I'm gonna do another round. So we copy and move it, and we align the arrows, and then we rotate it. Now we want to rotate it 7.5 degrees. So we have to do a little bit of a freehand rotation here, but this looks pretty good. Now we have 48 segments around the wheel, and if you make the wheel bigger, you can have more segments, and you just use the number of segments in your calculation. I'm gonna show you, but instead of numbers, now I place some different blocks around it. You'll get the idea anyway, like this. And now with 48 segments, I put the wheel speed to 1/2 of itself. That means that we need one rotation around will be 12.56. That's 2 times the tau constant, because it's set 0.5 speed. So that means 12.56 divided with 48 segments around the wheel. Just struggling a little bit with how to write this, because Roblox won't let me write it for you guys. I end up doing it just with letters, and I'm not sure I spell 48 the right way, but anyway, you get the idea. That equals 0.26. That is the time needed for the wheel to rotate around its axle, for it to change from one segment to the next one. I'm just gonna cut it, because I had some trouble with the wheel rotating the wrong direction. Let's see if this works out. It works as it should work. It changed one block each time, and that means if I'm here and I wanna go all the way to the fabric block right over here, if I would make that in one rotation, then I will need 6 times 0.26. That equals 1.56, meaning that 1.56 is the amount of time needed for the wheel to rotate to the fabric block. So if I change this delay to 1.56, it should rotate to the fabric block, and that is exactly what it does. So that is how this works. And now, for doing it as a calculator, you will need your wheel. Any wheel size can do, Now I just made the same one as in my original calculator. And you need numbers all the way around on the end here. And it would be so nice if you could just do it with the signs, in-game signs. But of course you cannot, because Roblox will tag your signs after a little while when you write a lot of numbers. They think you're gonna give away your parents' credit card number or something. So you cannot do that. You have to block up the numbers, and that takes a while, and I'm not gonna do that again in this tutorial, but you get the idea of what you have to do. I think it's not the part you're struggling with. So 12.056 again divided in 24, because this will only have 24 segments around it. And now we're gonna place 9 delay blocks, and the 9 delay blocks is going to be our 9 buttons on the calculator, going from 1 to 9 that you can add to the sum on the display of the calculator. So the first one is going to be 1. That means one change, that's 0.52. If I had double the amount of segments on the calculator on this one, it would be 26, but now it's 52. Now this is our 2 button, that would be the double, that's 1.04. And the next delay block is our 3 button, that means 3 times, it's 1.56. 4 times, that means 2.08. Then in our 5 times, 2.60, plus 6 button, that is 3.12. And our 7 button is 3.64. And then our 8 button is 4.16. And our 9 button is 4.68. You just place one button that you're gonna delete in a minute, and now you place one button for each of these delays, like this, and they connect correctly. Delete the spare one. And now you connect all the delays to the wheel, like this. And now you connect all the switches to the wheel, like this. So now these 9 buttons resembles the 1 to 9 digits on the calculator, the buttons that you're gonna press that will add a number from 1 to 9 to the sum on this display. And this one change it 1, and you can press one of the other buttons, it will change it 2 and 3 and 4 and so on. And this is how it works. So now I think I have given you everything you need to know to get going with your own calculator build, or some other stuff that uses this cool mechanics. And I hope it wasn't too heavy to understand. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe. And until next time, happy building. See you then.